Hey everybody, it's Tanya back with Shooting Star SVG, and previously we have gone through how to use pattern overlays in Photopea or Photoshop or whatever program you might have. It's the same process, and we've learned how to create a diagonal pattern that is seamless utilizing Silhouette Studio, a PNG conversion program, which I used Inkscape in my tutorial. And Photoshop to utilize your patterns. Today we're actually going to create a chevron pattern, and I will say for this, you will need Designer Plus Edition of Silhouette Studio. So if you do not have Designer Plus Edition or higher, you will not be able to follow along with this tutorial. I will post a link to upgrade through Swing Design, which is very cheap, and we'll go ahead and get started. So if you go to your FlexiShapes panel, there's a bunch of these things in here. And what I discovered is this little guy right here, you can use to create a chevron look. So we're just going to go ahead and draw it out. And then we're going to actually bring it in. If you hold your shift key down, it will stay aligned to where we like it. All right, and you're just going to click Convert to Path. Open up your Transform panel, and since this is a 6 by 6 inch workspace, I'm going to create a width and make sure your dimensions are locked of 1 inch, and that'll do 6 of these guys across. So you're going to go to your Transform panel. And you're going to align this thing in the middle of your workspace. Okay, so this is in the middle of the workspace. Very important that it's the middle and the edge. So you're going to have your x-axis at 0 and then align that in the middle. The next thing that you're going to do is you're going to open up your replicate panel and you're going to replicate this across 6 times. Okay. And then just select them all and hit Control G or come up here and click Group. Okay, now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go back to this Advanced Replicate. Okay, now we're going to be replicating up. So we're going to do a custom position. Okay. What we're going to be manipulating here is the y-axis. We don't want to move this left or right at all, so the x-axis is going to stay at 0. You're going to change this to whatever you feel comfortable with as far as spacing goes. So in my case, I'm going to go ahead and do a 1 inch spacing. Now keep in mind, when you do this, if you go too small, they're just going to stack on top of each other, okay? So you can see at a half a point, a half inch spacing, they just stack on each other. You don't want that. So I'm going to go ahead and start with a offset of 1 and click replicate. To get that same function to happen up above, you're just going to put a negative or a minus in front of your Y offset. All right. Go ahead and zoom out. You can delete the extras that you have on your page because you're not going to need those. Now, we're going to do the same thing that we did with the diagonal pattern. And you're just going to save it as an SVG. I'm just going to do Chevron test and click OK. Now, we go back and we open up our test in Inkscape. If it will ever open up. You can see that my export PNG is already up. You can open it by hitting Shift Control Echo or E. And again, make sure that the page is checked, export it where you want, and go. So we're going to go back to Photopea now that this is saved. And we're going to open up this test file. Okay. We're also going to create a new paper. We're going to click Edit, Define New Pattern. Okay. And when you go here, you're going to go to New Adjustment Layer, Pattern Fill, and you're going to click on your chevron pattern. Okay. And you can scale this thing up or down. And as you can see, there's no gaps. There are no lines. This thing is perfectly aligned. It is a beautiful, beautiful thing. When I first found out I could do this, I was like, what? I've been trying. I bought a few chevron patterns, and every time I broke them out, like, they had lines, and it was just super frustrating. Like, I got really frustrated with it. So, you can add that color fill layer, and that's just going to change that. If you want to change the color of the stripes, you can click on the background and click effect, click on color overlay, and you can change the color of the stripes to whatever you see fit, whatever works for you. And then that's all there is to it. That's going to give you that seamless chevron look. And I actually will have these overlays in my shop shortly, so I'll be sure to put the link underneath this if you don't want to go through the hassle. But if you feel like creating something that is your own and applying it to different digital papers to utilize as a background, this is a great way to do it and a great way to learn. So if you like this video, go ahead and click like and subscribe below. That is what keeps me motivated to continue making these and learning new things and sharing that with you guys. So if you have any questions or run into any problems with this process, feel free to let me know. I guess the other thing that I can... Well, no, you can get that from my other videos. I'm going to keep this short and sweet. So I hope you all have a great night. Bye-bye.